Minor local recording. Wouldn't be against that. Good. Alright, let's try to hit this, split. More or less there. Alright, so this is Karim Ulyaoth. Individual chapter. So the only difference from the old one is on this case is the barrier fight. Everything else is pretty much the same. And pretty much the same as before, and also pretty much the same as any person. I kinda got a hard time doing these PVs on Karim. Again, this is all offline and I'm commenting live over it. That's just some basic Karim stuff there, just getting the, room from the zombie. I got a hard time with this because there is a lot of... There is something about the barrier fight that happens about 1 out of 10 times, usually on runs. More or less, that's what I got. But when you do individual levels, that shit happens a lot more. It happens like half the times. So 1 out of, 2, it's just really rough. And we're gonna come to that later. I think it's on the Celta run. Maybe it's not on this one, but basically there is possibility of heavy lag on the last fight when we do a free cast setup, and it sucks. It's basically, it's just very slow. So I don't exactly remember if I got it on the Ulyaoth one. We'll see. So here there's some a little bit of manipulation on zombies. I just like to do that because it makes that room easier later, having those zombies attack there. Kinda gives better movement for later, and then 3 attacks on the back, 1 on the front, and change the chakrams, and the horror is about to die, and it's gonna die on the chakram there, if I can land it. So yeah, by the way, take into account, these runs aren't the best. The main objective of these runs, Jesus, that was rough menu, was just to update. Look at that, even losing time on the first split. I wanted to update individual levels because there is kind of enough stuff to make up for PVs without a lot of effort on my part, at least. Like I run these things enough to get a decent time, but not enough to, you know, optimize it at all. These are not optimized at all. It's mostly about, almost about documentation. I'm watching this cutscene mostly because I just didn't want to hear the rats over and over. That's the only reason why I'm watching that one. You're gonna see introduction in all these individual levels, actually. We might leave the rats for 20%, but I also had the small theory that introduction might be faster, but I haven't looked into it. I'm a little bit lazy because that's like you have to record watching it a bunch of times and then analyze it in the software, and that's a lot of work. I mean, it's not that much, but it's tedious. It's just not feeling like that. So there's a no magic message there that you do before this cutscene that allows you to move, allows you to input a pause, and then with the pause you can move. And there's like a tiny room there where you move outside of the camera and you fight the bone thief zombies. And then you can do the enchant there in such a way that it merges with the cutscene of the gate. So you see there, the zombies are in a very good position for me to don't get blocked by them. Should be around there. So yeah, pretty tight with the previous one, because the main time save is coming up here on this last fight. And pretty much the only difference. So we get past this gate. After this gate, we're gonna do a spell. The spell is just to set up a free cast. The free cast, we're gonna do a free enchant. And with the free enchant, we're gonna move into the cutscene. The enchant is gonna finish in the cutscene, and that allows you to move and go past the barrier. And for some reason, I unequipped the sword. Just got it wrong there. And then you can fight here, which is way faster, because you don't have to wait for the zombies to walk outside of the barrier. And all these cutscenes are to unload enemies that are on finishing state. And here I was kind of low in magic. Normally I, well, not normally, but depending on how magic goes, I can do 2 normal recoveries, but if you don't have enough, it's kind of safe to go for a talisman. Now that triggers the horror. Now we're gonna kill the horror with this unload. Then a no magic message into a pause to move. And then we're gonna move into the trigger. One of the triggers, but I failed it, sadly. Forgot that I failed that. But regardless, still BB. So I can go way faster. It was kind of sloppy. I probably even got it better on runs, but as for the rules of discotery, you gotta do it from jump to game. The idea on the last part is that there is a trigger that is the same trigger that activates this fight.
Who did this to you?
And every time you cross the trigger, you can make the cutscene advance a little bit. So normally you want to wait a little bit until the cutscene advances just a tiny bit, and when you are like in the close to the last part of the cutscene, or rather, you're like one section of the cutscene before the last one, let's say,
so much for
thinking. Then you can finish it by crossing the trigger. But I failed it, and then I got lost on the camera, because the camera sucks. It's a different strat from what I used to do in the past. And yeah, that's Ulyaoth Karim.
If we are to be together again, you must make a sacrifice. Only when that is complete will we
make a sacrifice.
Together.
Exactly.
Sacrifice.
Should I do anything for you?
Anything for you? You lied to me, betrayed me. You really don't look so good anymore.
You must forget the past. Despite who you are now, you will also become something more, just as I have. But the sacrifice must be made. We must remain here and
yeah, the main reason why I did this offline is because I've been struggling a little bit with stream. But I'm still like active on speedrun. I wanted to speedrun just without the pressure of streaming, more or less. Yo, Makoto, how are you doing? Come to the stream. Let's see for Ulyaoth. We're gonna go for the next one now. We won't go for Karim immediately, okay?